All right, Riley. So obviously, Toronto Arrow's injury situation has been kind of crazy. What's the last week been like for you, joining the team halfway through the season here?
You know what? It's been good. The boys have been incredibly supportive with kind of giving me whatever I need and helping me talk through all the plays and everything. But it's good to be back in the environment with all the boys and everybody.
Yeah, I heard you were like teaching in Poland as late as like a week ago. So like,
yeah.
How did that go with like getting the call to kind of? Have you been following the team, like the story behind like what's been going on at the injury situation and stuff, or like how surprised were you to get that phone call?
I've been teaching preschool in Poland, in Warsaw, which has been a lot of fun, playing a little bit of club rugby out there, and I've been following the boys and kind of chatting with my dad, and when I guess a couple of the injuries started coming in, we were joking about getting a call or not, and then it started happening, and I got a text from Winnie after the game last weekend, and it's like, hey, can you come out and play? And I obviously want to come help the boys out and come back and play some good rugby. So
You had a great first half there. How are you feeling after sort of returning to Major League Rugby for the first time in a couple of years?
Thanks for saying I had a great half. I honestly feel a lot better than I expected to be. So I feel really good right now and ready to go again next week and put in some hard work this week.
Perfect. And obviously, pretty exciting game at the end. What are just your thoughts on the game in general, how it played out? You guys got off to a big lead a couple of times. Old Glory was able to come back, but you were able to kind of hold them off at the end.
Yeah, I thought the boys were working hard. We worked really hard, and when things started not going on our way, I think it was just discipline, making sure we were getting onside. We gave away a few too many penalties, which kept them in the game, but when we worked hard and stayed disciplined is when we were showing well on the field.
All right, Mitch, so first off, man, congrats on your first MLR start. How'd you kind of feel out there today?
It was really good. I was really excited, a little nervous before, but I've had some playing time before, so I was pretty confident, and then when I got out there, it just loosened up, and it went well. So.
Yeah, and I mean, like, your game got off to a great start for yourself there. You played a big part in the opening try of the game for the Arrows. So what did you kind of see as that play sort of developed there?
I mean, Mitchie made a great break down the middle. Then I tried to catch up with him, get the ball, and then I knew me and Connor were down there trying to work some kind of 2-on-1, and I mean, I think managed to get a little fortunate breaking the first tackle and then got the ball away, which was good. And then, yeah, I got off the ground, I saw Connor had scored, and I was pretty fired up.
And obviously later in the game too, you kind of benefited off a great kick there from Sam Malcolm. Yeah. Have you guys been working on that? How did that play sort of come about? Did you know it was coming and to just kind of like run on it, or what was going through your head there?
Yeah, I got all credits to Sam on that one. His call and his execution, I just happened to be there. But one of the big things we've been working on is a lot of communication beforehand and talking, little talk between us in the game. And I think that definitely played a part. So we all knew what was happening before that came out.
Yeah, so this is obviously first time this year the Arrows to put up more than 30 points, big 5-point bonus point victory here as well. What kind of like do you feel like click for the offense and the attack today?
Yeah, I think we just managed to execute a lot of our skills. Like we held the ball and didn't make too many like unforced errors there. Ball was working really well. And managed to benefit off a couple around the side too. I think just execution was a lot better today.
All right, so Pete, what were kind of your thoughts on the game there? Arrows got off to a pretty big lead, kind of let Old Glory come back, but with two men in the bin where the defense came up big and was able to get the win for you guys.
Yeah, it was a strange old game. I thought we were really good ball in hand, and we certainly jumped out to a decent lead there in that second half. On attack, we were able to build phases, play quick, play to the edges, and we scored some really good tries and played some really entertaining rugby. Unfortunately, just discipline, discipline let them in the game. We gave away far too many penalties, far too many offside penalties, allowed them to get in a half, and they were able to take advantage of it. The cards did hurt us a little bit. It's always tough towards the end of the game playing with 14 men and then down to 13 men at the end there. But I mean, credit to our team. They fight for each other. They fight in front of their home fans, and we really dug deep at the end there and were able to come away with the win.
And obviously you guys have had a real tough injury situation this year, especially having to bring in both Riley Di Nardo and Gordon McCrory as scrum halves this week. How do you feel that they did in their first game back, and how has been integrating them into the system halfway through the season like this?
They did outstanding, didn't they, on such short notice. Riley came in and trained with us on Thursday. Gordon was only here for the captain's run. Riley's been with the team since the start, so he knows a lot of our systems, he knows a lot of the guys. I thought he was outstanding. We were lucky enough to have him be playing out in Europe as well. So coming in fresh. I thought he was really good, and it was actually his first start for us since he's been with us. And yeah, I thought he was outstanding. Gordy was great coming off the bench too. I mean, to bring a guy that experience, that good on it around the 50th minute, 40th minute, he really closed down the game for us. And he was overplaying in Italy as well, and so he was coming off the back of the season. So both of them were outstanding, and without them, it would have been a different result today.
Yeah, do you guys have any like update on the injury situation? Is there anybody that you're looking forward to possibly coming back within the next week or so?
Yeah, so we should have a few guys coming back sort of within the next 2-3 weeks. We were able to get Spencer Jones back this week, and he finished the game for us and finished really strong. Hopefully Matt Wood should be available next week. We've got Gaston Mieres, Tommy De La Vega, not too far away. So we should get most of our squad back at the business end of the season, but we've had a horror run with injuries, haven't we? But it's given opportunities to some other guys, and they've played outstanding. We've been in the hunt, we've been thereabouts, or thereabouts, and it's crazy to think we've got 14, 15 guys out and still able to put in some really, really good performances.
And going into next week, is there anything you guys are going to, based on this game, kind of looking to focus on during training this week?
Well, discipline, definitely. Our ability to finish tries as well. We had a few line breaks there, and we broke them open a few times. We weren't able to capitalize and turn it into points, or we let ourselves down in the next phase or the phase after. So definitely finishing off would be one. And defensively, it's just our discipline. We allow teams in the game too easily, unfortunately. So definitely got to fix those two things.
All right, Paul, congrats on the win there. Big bonus point victory for you guys. Just what are your thoughts on the game? You got out to a pretty big lead. Old Glory was able to come back, but big defensive stand at the end there lets you walk away with the W.
Yeah, I mean, we really hammered home what we could do, moving points of contact, getting tip balls in, moving the ball out wide, and really working, making their team work. And I thought we did that really well. Yeah, they definitely gave us a scare, but we let our defense speak for ourselves at the end there and really stopped them and dug deep with two yellow cards in. So I'm pretty proud of that performance.
Yeah, so like what was kind of the message to the team as you guys were sort of preparing for that big defensive stand there, knowing, like you said, you're down two guys, probably, down two guys might be a tough situation to let the ball get out of that maul, but you were able to shut it down.
Yeah, just, I think most important thing is just knowing your role going into it and making sure you execute, whether that be little skills of communication, just talking, and then just the basics of making your tackles, in the maul, what's your role and where to go from there. And, boys executed it perfectly, I thought, and it shows because we got the ball back and, secured the victory at the end.
Yeah, for sure. And you guys obviously, bonus point win, first time this season putting up 30 points. It's like, what do you kind of feel like worked for you guys today as you're working through the phases, creating a lot of gaps in like the defense and able to put a lot of tries on the board there?
Yeah, I think just really working the ball through the hands, making them make their decisions on who we got to tackle, and from there move the ball to the right, like where the spaces are, right? They're a heavy defense team. They like to come up, rush, blitz. So, they're going two on tackle. So just those little tips, getting guys running through gaps. Just seeing space is really what I guess we tried to hammer home, right?
Yeah, for sure. And so going into next week, last half of the season, still plenty of home games left. How much have you guys been enjoying playing back home in Toronto, getting the first win on home soil in since 2019, since that drop goal game, I guess.
Yeah, it's been a crazy, 1,000 days, 3 years of just feel like you've been on the road the entire time. It's quite a feat, and I guess a bit surreal, I'd say. Still being here, it's wonderful hearing people cheer for you rather than always having someone else cheer against you. So hopefully we can make this place a fortress like we made Lamport back in 2019, and it's just great, really great getting that support from all the fans, friends, family, everybody. Again, it really means a lot, and we all appreciate you on the team. Thank you very much.